that 200. She was coming around that curve. Just Gwen, she was everything. She was it. That body, her hair, nails, everything. Just always on point. So Gwen Torrence. I am just happy to be here. I'm just here in this Olympic year for myself, just to be here to celebrate someone who has participated in 3 Olympic Games. That is just so important. Consistently being the best in the world, being at the top of your game, traveling to over 20 countries, interviews. I mean, and it was the time that she was running, it was one of just the most competitive, whether it's Gail Devers, Flojo. And in 1996, they considered her to be the fastest woman in the world.
Woo!
So, I mean, it's just amazing. For someone who, in PE, I read an article, and it was, she started running track from doing PE, and she always wanted to wear pumps and tight jeans, you know, just wanted to look good, look cute. So her high school coach actually convinced her to start running track, you know, lose the pumps just for, you know, set them down for a little bit. So she managed to get a full scholarship to the University of Georgia, and she still managed to win best dress in high school. Helps. So I am really honored just to be here to celebrate her tonight. So I'm sure the video can highlight even just more of her illustrious career.
The 2016 Sports Award recipient, Ms. Gwen Torrence. In 1995, Gwen Torrence was ranked number one in the 100 meters and the 200 meters by track and field, and was widely respected as the fastest woman in the world. Growing up in Decatur, Georgia, she attended Columbia High School, where she was recruited to the University of Georgia. From there, she would qualify and compete in the Olympics, 88, 92, and 1996. Where she would compete and come away with 3 gold medals, 1 silver and 1 bronze.
Go! Gwen Torrence. Gwen Torrence.
The 2016 Sports Award recipient, Ms. Gwen Torrence.
Gwen Torrence.
Woo! Good job, baby. Boy, thank you.
This is Miss Best Dress coming up here, holding it down still.
Gwen Torrence.
I was just getting ready to run that race. I want to give honor to my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who's the head of my life. I want to thank my mom, who gave birth to me. May she rest in peace. I want to also give thanks to 5 special men in my life. The first person is my high school friend. He's been my best friend for 10 years. If it wasn't for him, I don't know how I would have gotten to track practice. He took me to school. He encouraged me to run track. He encouraged me more than I encouraged myself, my best friend, James. Hey, James.
Yay! Hey.
My high school coach, I did not want to run track. I wanted to go to cosmetology school. He kept saying, Gwen, you can go to cosmetology school anytime, but don't many young black girls get to go to the University of Georgia on a full scholarship? I'm like, well, doing hair has nothing to do with me running. He encouraged me to go to school. He took me to school. Before he can get back to Decatur, I was back with him. He had to take me back to school because I didn't want to go. But throughout the years, track became more important to me than I expected. When I was a little girl, growing up in the projects of East Lake Meadows, I didn't have a dream. My dream was to stay alive. My best friend, she died when I was 8 years old. My friend next door, he died when he was 20. And my dad died when I was 9. So my dream was to stay alive. And I never saw young black girls run track, nevertheless go to college, nevertheless earn money from it, and neither did I know. All I knew is what I wanted to take care of my mom. I didn't know how I was gonna do it, but I wanted to take care of my mother. My high school coach encouraged me to run track, and he's here with me today, Coach Bonner.
Gwen Torrence.
But I didn't feel like working out. Many days I didn't feel like running. Many days I didn't want to run when it was raining and I didn't want to mess up my hair. And to this day, he still called me knucklehead. Like, I'm 50 years old. I'm a woman now. So I want to thank you, Coach Bonner, for encouraging me and being there for me throughout my career. My second coach is my college coach, Coach Gainey. He's here with me tonight.
Yeah.
He had problems with me and this hair of mine. He would tell me many times, Gwen, if you're not on time, that bus is gonna leave you. Gwen was on time, but she did have the hair fixed. So I wanna thank you, Coach Gainey, for encouraging me and being there for me when I finished my last year of college. He tried to be my agent. He didn't know what he was doing, but Coach Gainey got me my first $300. And I thought I was rich. I ran for 6 seconds and I got $300. And that was enough for me. I moved up from 300 to 500. When he got me to 800, he started to panic. We're like, Gwen, I can't do this no more. You gotta get somebody. Eventually convinced me to go with another manager, which was my agent. And I want to thank you, Coach Gainey, for at least trying to give me a couple of coins because we were broke. And I want to thank their wives because they dedicated a lot of time to track and field for their athletes. And I want to thank Ms. Bonner and Ms. Gainey for loaning me your husband, loaning our whole track team, the whole football team, and loaning them to us. I appreciate that. And for the most important person in my life on track and field, I want you to come up here, Manly.
Manly!
This is my ex-husband, and we were married for 15 years. And I haven't had the moment to do it, and I thought this would be the great time to do it. Manly, I want to thank you for dedicating 15 years of your life to me. And when your career ended, you dedicated yourself to me. You were more determined and dedicated to me than I was to myself. I thank you for running through the airport with all my bags when I was running late. When his career ended, I'm real nervous, everybody. When his career ended, Manly used to come out to the track with me. He couldn't run as fast as me. He couldn't last as long as me. But we would get up in the morning, go for a 2 mile run. He'll give me a good 5 minutes. He'll say, I can't go no more. You got to go on your own. And I'll take off and I'll do my own thing. But he'll pick me up when I came back up the hill and he'll take me in. When I was on the track, we would do our intervals. He would start with me. He'll end with me, but he couldn't go the whole way. And I just want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for being there for me, still being my friend after all this time. And I had won some gold some years ago. And I always said I was going to keep this gold until a rainy day. The day hasn't rained, but I cashed it in. This is a small token of my appreciation.
Millie!
Like my brother,
Slick. No money,
but you and your wife, y'all have a good vacation on me. That's but not least, the dream that I live today, I'm doing what I've always wanted to do. People ask me all the time, why aren't you a trainer? Why don't you coach? Why don't you do this? But that's not what I wanted to do. I'm not ashamed to be a hairstylist. I love it. I have my own business. I'm living my dream. I love the stories I get in my chair. I make women beautiful. I make women feel good. I make them cry. But I love what I do today. And I share my dream that I live today with my husband of today.
Oh.
Jody. So now, my three husbands have passed the torch to my husband. he has a difficult job of taking care of the 50-year-old real woman. So I appreciate you and everything that you do for me, everything you do for the salon for me, and dedicating your life to me. And I brought my daughter here. She's 16. Iman, will you stand up?
Woohoo!
For her to see what greatness is. She don't understand my life because she wasn't there 16 years ago. And she always saying, Mama, why everybody ask you for your autograph? Well, that's been a long time ago. You're not famous anymore. No, I love it because she keeps me grounded. She always saying, you're just my mom. She's like, this is so weird to me. So I want her to see what greatness was amongst everybody. And I thank you, Legendary Awards, for nominating, for honoring me and thinking about me for this year, and it's been really, really great. I appreciate it.
Yeah!
Yeah, that was a good one, man. Yeah, I'm gonna try to get my hair in.
Are you ready?